Yes, the disaster risk management normally is shared by the chairperson of the Khomas Regional Council at the regional level, and the constituency one is shared by the constituency councillors. And by the Decentralization Act, it normally used to sit once per month, but because of the current COVID-19 pandemic now, we have reactivated this disaster risk management to at least sit once per week. And it started from the one of the regional council as well as the constituency one. And I also must make it clear here that it is through the risk disaster management that we, people that must receive food stuff. That is also another aspect that I will probably go back to. The identification, the registration, and the distribution is actually done by the risk disaster management at the constituency level. So that is put on their shoulder, and they are really doing a very good job, because it is not very difficult, very easy for them to distribute food, but they are doing well. I should have also mentioned that Khomas Regional Council have been distributing food parcels to our people that normally we get from the government through the office of the OPM, or we have private donations or individual donations. So in that way, we are able to help our people who cannot make ends meet. And also, we have also benefited from the emergency income grant that my brother here mentioned, of the 750, although we know some people are still making noise and crying that they have not benefited. We do not dispute that fact. But Khomas Region actually benefited with a number of 134,583. And these are the people that have registered Khomas as a region, and they all benefited. Remember, we were also told that water must be given free of charge by the government, and we have also done that very well, because we have given water tokens to our people, and the water currently that was given for free of charge by the city of Windhoek stand at a cost of 1.9 million. That, I think, it's quite an amount. We have also reconnected the water that were disconnected because of debt. All those that owed the municipality their water got deconnected, so they also benefited through that same scheme. And not forgetting, when you look at Khomas Region, we have 10 constituencies. 9 of them are within the boundaries of the city of Windhoek, but then we have one which we refer to as Windhoek Rural. Within Windhoek Rural, we have also drilled some boreholes. We drilled 15 boreholes, 22 solar pumps, and 20 cattle troughs. That is in our rural area. And not to forget, so that the viewers also be aware, that within Khomas Region, we have relocated those people that we refer to as people without shelter, that are currently housed at Katutura Youth Multipurpose Center. There we have got a number of 317 men and women and children, and as well at Khomas Dal Soccer Stadium, we have a number of 124. And not forgetting that we have also mobile pockets, people that either are refusing to be relocated to those centers. You find them in Klein Coupe at the airport and so on. So those ones stand at 102. We provided accommodation in tents. Some of them are housed in the multi-purpose youth center of Katutura. And we give them water, we give them food. So it's something that we are now trying to find a way how best to deal with it in terms of post-COVID strategic plan, so that when we are told that now we are done with COVID-19, what happens to these people? So we are reintegrating them, we are repatriating them, some of them back to their regions and so on. That's not a very easy exercise, but it must be done and it has to be done. So currently we are busy with that one.
Thank you for that.